Okay. This is Artifacts of Mars. And I heard about Privilege Institute on Jim Quinn Show, warroom.com. Thank you very much. We're going to take a good look at this. I didn't know there was such a thing. I knew that these white privileged people were working. I knew, you know, basically they wanted to get rid of all whitey, remove all whitey from the planet, but I didn't know they're this organized. I knew somebody had to be organizing them. I didn't know about they were organized by this particular organization. I didn't know they existed. Here we have, this is like their about page. It's the privilegeinstitute.com is the address. Understanding and Dismantling Journal is an interdisciplinary journal focusing on the intersectional aspects of privilege, bringing academia in practice, highlighting activism, offering a forum for creating introspection on issues of inequality, power, and privilege. In other words, it's like the Mein Kampf of these people. Check out the most recent issue here. The goals of the journal are to create a forum for research and creative work that critically examines issues of privilege, power, oppression, white supremacy, and social justice. To encourage examination of intersections of systems of privilege and oppression, including but not limited to race, ethnicity, sex, gender, sexuality, class, nationality, and ability, disability. To provide a space for self-reflection, bridging personal and political. To bring theory and practice, we will provide a forum for sharing curriculum, programming tools, strategies, and best practices. To foster interdisciplinary dialogue, to encourage the development of and provide opportunities for learning from school youth voices. So they're teaching basically, like I said, this is fascism. This is the equivalent of the Ku Klux Klan, but instead of being made up of whites hating other races, this is made up of other races hating whites. That's the bottom line. And they actively encourage hate. And nobody is standing up. There are talk show hosts like Jim Quinn who are saying things about them. Nobody in our government is going to stand up and say, hey, this is wrong, this is fascism, it's racism. They'll do anything they can to stop white supremacist groups, which is fine, but now they're, here we have a supremacist group that's against one race. These are the Nazis of the modern era. I got some other stuff to show you. Hang on. Okay, here's their journal. You'll never see a white person on here unless they're looking at the person in a negative light. Like a skinhead up on your right, for instance. Looks like a skinhead. So, anyway, here we have, these people have been active for quite some time. White Privilege Conference has been around for 17 years, which means they've been operating in this country for a lot longer than Nazis did before they took over. They are trying to take over. This is about power, and I'm going to explain how this works. It's the oldest political trick in the book. You turn the people against a certain group. You turn the people against something in order to unite them. that's human nature. You get them united against something, then you have your power over them. That's basic human nature. These are fascists who know this, and they are using whites to attack. They are using whites to gain their power because this is what they want. Now, ironically, they call white privilege conference for this year, Let Freedom Ring. They hate freedom. They hate representative government. They want to destroy representative government and institute a fascist regime of some kind. But take a look at this. Let's take a look at the members of this Center for the Study of White American Culture. I'll do them in a later state. They, Bryn Mawr College, FGC Friends, American Friends, Service Community, Friends, Council on Education. I'm going to have to look those up because I'm not familiar. Take a look at this. Pennsylvania Council of Churches. So maybe we'll take a quick look at them. You see why I'm an agnostic, folks? Here we have a religious organization, the Pennsylvania Council of Churches. They are participating in an anti-white racist organization. And they have the nerve to tell me that I need to get down on my knees to someone that can't even prove exists and ask for forgiveness. Well, I'm sorry. I've been that rude. I can't believe this. Here we have Pennsylvania Council Churches is in with one of the most evil organizations in this country. I'm going after these people on YouTube. This is not going to be the last thing. Let's take a look at some of the others. Sierra Club. No surprise there. The Wacko Environmentalism. Western Theological Seminary. That might be worth taking a quick look at. Yeah, it's a school. Alright. Yeah, these are so-called Christians, and yet they are participating in the hatred and eventually the genocide against whites. This is inexplicable. I have no words. This is completely inexplicable. What the hell's wrong with them? This is why I'm an agnostic. Folks, well, this isn't the only reason, but, if you're white, you're scum. And yet, here's a white woman standing in the podium. It's inexplicable. I have no explanation. It's beyond my ability to comprehend. Hope College. I'm going to have to do a series on these scumbags because this is a lot bigger than I thought. I knew it was big. I knew things were going on. But I didn't know what the organizations were behind this. I'm going to call it for now. This is not going to be the last. I might actually start up a new playlist if I can find some good music for it. Well, these are Nazis. They hate freedom. They hate representative government. They're not the Nazis, but they're the same basic type of thing. Their beliefs are the same. Extermination of the white race. And you have whites sitting right here. It's inexplicable. I mean, the so-called Privilege Institute, make no mistake, they want genocide against whites. Make no mistake about it. If you think they want anything else, I got a bridge in Brooklyn that I'll sell you for $100. Big, big bridge. Of course, you'll have to take over the maintenance on it, but if you think these people want anything less than the extermination of the white race, I got news for you. So I'm going to have to go over some of this. This is going to take time, boy. I got other things to do. But wake up, people. I've tried to warn you. I'm trying to warn you. I'm going to continue trying to warn you until people wake up and stop this. These people have got to be stopped. It's like I said before, what's more moral? Stopping them now or waiting until they kill 100 million people? This is pure evil on the march. They hate freedom. They hate everything about this country. Pure, unadulterated evil. And here's more of this. There's going to be more videos. I am so going to go after these sons of bitches. And I'm not just going after them on YouTube. I'm going after all these motherfuckers who are participating in this. I am so going to expose as many of these as I have time for. I don't have time to sit here and do videos all day. I wish I did. You know, I wish I was independently wealthy so I could sit here and do videos and blast these people. But I'm not, so I have to work for a living. You gotta wake up. You got to get the word out what's going on. Nazis had plenty of friends like this, too. And yes, Nazis had support from the church. It's the same thing. Only this time it's whites that are on the list, not Jews. That doesn't mean that people of color are safe. Absolutely not. You are not safe from these scumbags. I'm going to go for now. This won't be the last you're going to hear. I promise you that. This won't be the last. I'll deal with it as I can. I'm going to repeat the Green Lantern oath before I go. Even though it's fictional, of course, but in the brightest day and darkest night, no evil shall escape my sight. Let those who worship evil's might beware my power, Green Lantern's light. I'm Artifacts of Mars. Thanks for watching. This won't be the last.